Why do Democrats always cave in, even with the majority in the Senate? They can't get anything done. It's because we've got a lot of bad Democrats out there. Let's be honest about it. We've got bad Democrats. And by bad Democrats, I of course mean the corporatists. I mean the Democrats who are out there protecting people who ought not be in office anymore. I think at this point, there is a general consensus among the Democratic voters, among the public in general for certain, that Diane Feinstein needs to resign from office yesterday. Okay? I don't think there's any more question about that. But remember like a month ago, when we were all saying these things and Nancy Pelosi came out and said that that's just sexism? Like you're being misogynistic by saying that Diane Feinstein should resign? And then, of course, a couple weeks later, she talks to a reporter, doesn't remember that she was even gone for 3 months. We get all these reports about how the staffers have basically been propping her up Weekend at Bernie's style, making sure that she's never left alone. And Nancy Pelosi protected her all the way because, as the reports tell us, it's because Pelosi wants Schiff to have that Senate seat. And she's afraid if Feinstein resigns that Gavin Newsom is going to appoint Barbara Lee to the Senate seat, which would basically guarantee she would win a primary. And then Schiff is gone. Pelosi loses her little buddy. So when I say we have bad Democrats, that's what I mean. They're more concerned about preserving and protecting their own power than they are about actually doing good things for the public. Chuck Schumer, back when he was minority leader in the Senate, he cut deals with Mitch McConnell all the time to fast-track Donald Trump's judicial appointments. In fact, one time, as we were getting close to the December break for the Senate, they were going to have to stay later into what should have been their vacation days because of all the backlog of appointees. Schumer cut a deal with Mitch McConnell to go ahead and greenlight all of those nominees just so they could hurry up and go on vacation. So Schumer cut a deal because he wanted some time off to pack the courts with Republican judicial hacks. Then, of course, we've got bad Democrats like Joe Manchin, former Democrat Kyrsten Sinema. We've got plenty of them in the House of Representatives. It's not even a majority of bad Democrats, but there are enough bad Democrats to where the good ones in Congress aren't able to do the things that the public needs them to do. And unfortunately, you have too many yahoos out there who want to tell you that because there are a few bad Democrats, that Democrats are somehow just as bad as Republicans. I don't buy into that crap. I mean, there's a couple of issues, sure, like foreign policy, let's be clear about that, where there's not a ton of daylight between Republicans and Democrats. They're always going to feed the war machine, and I hate that. But you can't sit here with a straight face and tell me that Democrats are no different than Republicans when we have one party that is literally out there state by state trying to legislate people out of existence. Democrats may be incompetent sometimes, but they're damn sure not evil like the Republicans are. And if we could actually get rid of the bad Democrats, then we wouldn't even be having that conversation anymore either.